Hi, welcome back. In this lecture, I'll be dealing with the reproductive system in insects. Insects have got very high reproductive capacity. In fact, one of the important reasons for dominance of insects is their capacity to produce more number of offsprings. They are master exploiters of environmental conditions. Whenever food is plentiful, they produce more number of offsprings. In fact, the reproductive organs are located from the posterior abdominal segments, but they are extended towards the anterior abdominal segments. So both in case of male reproductive system or the female reproductive system. Combining with the external genitalia, they have the ability to reproduce more number of offsprings. And in case of male, the main structure, which is now oedipus, through which these sperms are transmitted to the female reproductive organ, whereas the external genitalia of female is called ovipositor, through which they lay the eggs on the substratum. So in this class, we'll discuss about the internal organs concerned with the reproduction. Insects have got varieties of reproductive modes. In fact, few insects reproduce asexually, that means parthenogenetically. However, many of the insects reproduce sexually. So wherever sexual reproduction occurs, the male and female sexes are separate. Male reproductive system functions as production, storage, and delivery of sperms to female. Whereas the main function of female reproductive system is reception of sperms, production and storage of eggs, providing necessary nutrients for embryo development, and deposition of eggs. The structure of reproductive organs varies from species to species. However, in general, whether it is a male or female reproductive organ, it consists of a pair of gonads where eggs or sperms are synthesized. And they are collected through lateral duct. And then they make an exit through common duct. It may be oviduct or so ejaculatory duct. So then it enters into the oedipus in case of male or ovipositor in case of female. So let us discuss about the male reproductive system. So the male reproductive system consists of a pair of testes. So in fact, this testes consists of number of testicular follicles. So in order to now understand more, so I'm expanding one of the testes. So each testes consists of number of testicular follicles. So these testicular follicles synthesize these sperms or spermatocytes, which later develop as sperms. Okay, so the spermatocytes or the collections of the testicular follicles are moved down through small duct called vasa efferens. So like that, all these spermatocytes which are synthesized within the testicular follicles will be moved down into the much larger duct called vasa deferens. So this is the vasa deferens. So this vasa deferens is enlarged, which is called seminal vesicle, where these sperms are stored temporarily. So this vasa deferens has got connection to the one or more pairs of accessory glands. So these accessory glands mainly produces seminal fluid, which nourishes the sperms. In many insects, it also produces spermatophore, where these sperms are encased. That means placed inside a protein like protein encasement, through which that spermatophore is in fact transferred to the female reproductive tract. So the vasa deferens as well as the secretions of accessory glands are moved down through the common ejaculatory duct into the oedipus, which is a male external genitalia, which is helpful to transmit the sperms to female reproductive tract. So testes in fact lie above or below the gut in the abdomen. So sometimes they may be extended towards the almost all the anterior abdominal segments. So the testicular follicles present inside the testes may be unifollicular. There may be only one follicle, like Coleopteran adipaega, Aterygotans, except Thysanura, and also it is found in case of Diptera. Whereas these testicular follicles may be more number, like it's called multifollicular. So there may be 100 in case of grasshoppers, Acridiidae. So the accessory glands mainly perform the function of secretion of semilin fluid, which nourishes the sperms. So they also produce spermatophore that encase and protect the sperms. So this spermatophore, in fact, sperm packets will be transferred to the female reproductive tract. So however, in some insects, these accessory glands have modified into different structures. Like in case of cockroach, where these accessory glands are modified like mushrooms. So that's why they are called mushroom glands. So let us discuss about the general structure of female reproductive system. So the female reproductive system consists of a pair of ovaries. So each of these ovaries consists of number of ovarioles. So these ovarioles in fact arranged side by side like this. So there may be hundreds of such ovaries in a single insect, or there may be one or two in few insects. So particular ovary consists of terminal filament, germerium, vitellarium and pedicel. So this is the place, germerium is the place where the oocytes are synthesized, and these whatever the oocytes which are synthesized will be now nourished with the help of nurse cells, and the matured eggs will be moved down. So it will be now temporarily stored in terminal oocyte, and then they will be moved through the pedicel into the lateral oviduct. So it moves here. So collections of all the ovaries will be moved to the lateral oviduct, and then they move to the common oviduct. So one or two pairs of now accessory glands may be present in the common oviduct, and they perform different functions. And in addition to the accessory glands, there must be a very important gland called spermatheca gland, attached with a sac-like structure called spermatheca. So this spermatheca gland, in fact, now dissolve the spermatophore, the sperm packet, so that sperms will be now will be ready for the fertilization of eggs, which will be coming through the common oviduct. So, and also it now spermatheca, in fact, now nourishes the sperms where the sperms are stored for now days, months, years, depending on the species. So in fact, the sperms are from the adipocytes, sperms are placed inside the vagina or the bursa capillatrix, and then they will be moved inside the spermatheca. Okay, so this is the gonopore, and through which now they are connected to ovipositor, so that they lay the eggs on the substrate, I mean inside the soil or on the leaves, in the leaves, like that, depending on the species. So the number of ovaries varies from 1 to 2000. So maximum number of ovaries are found in termites. So we know that termites on daily basis, it can produce 3000 to 15000 number of eggs. It is mainly attributed to more number of ovaries it possesses. Whereas cockroach, Periplaneta americana, has 8 ovaries on each side. So columbellan ovarial is not exactly like insects, hence they are called non-insect and hexapoda. In fact, they are actually look like sac. Vivipara species, that is those insects which lay the young ones directly, exhibit extreme reduction in number of ovaries, whereas the egg-laying insects possess more number of ovaries. Some vivipara aphids have only one functional ovarial. So each ovary may consist of only one ovarial, whereas in some species there is actually only one functional ovary. Each ovary of the queen termite has over 2000 ovarial, and that of queen honeybee is about 150 to 180. So that means the number of ovaries inside the ovary varies from species to species. So accessory glands, I was telling that, see, accessory glands are usually attached to the common oviduct. So generally one or two pairs will be there, and commonly involved in secretion of adhesive material. So in cockroach, their secretion forms a capsule called ootheca. So eggs are placed in a capsule-like structure, which will be placed in the cracks and crevices. In grasshoppers and mantids, they secrete egg pod or egg case. So that means this adhesive material will be mixed with the egg, and then it will be placed on twigs or somewhere. So in female worker honeybees, they are modified as poison glands. Okay, so this is a very important thing. So in fact, this is the reason why, so that sting is, ovipositor is modified as sting, and they directly deposit this defensive fluid inside the victim body. So, and in some insects, it also secretes protein-rich eggshell, which is actually chorion. So that means the secretions of accessory glands, the functions varies from species to species. So now we'll move on to the types of reproduction. So I was telling that majority of the insects reproduce sexually. However, few species of insects also reproduce asexually. So the advantage of sexual reproduction is that there will be hybrid vigor, and there will be diversity of population. However, the disadvantage is that it takes two individuals to reproduce. Okay, so male and female will be there, in far places, and so they have to have a well-developed pheromone communication system. So they should come in contact and mate and reproduce. Whereas asexual reproduction, there is no need of two individuals. The advantage is that there will be a rapid life cycle and fast growth. However, little or no genetic variability will be there, because there will not be any mating. So genes movement to the offspring will be very less. So no genetic variability in case of asexual reproduction. So now we'll concentrate on the sexual reproduction. So sexual reproduction involves no mating of two individuals. And some circumstances, they may lay the eggs directly, or they may lay the eggs, young ones, directly. So based on that, so two types of oviparous reproduction has been identified, sexual reproduction has been identified. One is called oviparous, another is called viviparous. So oviparous means the egg-laying insects. So the egg-laying insects are called oviparous. Here, the fertilized eggs deposited outside for subsequent development. So majority of the insects, in fact, they mate and lay the eggs. Whereas many of the insect species also lay the young ones directly. So egg development takes place within the mother. Okay, so either in the hemocoel or in the reproductive tract. So eggs, you know, hatches inside and the young ones are deposited. So here the embryo nourishment directly takes place from the parent itself. Okay, so in fact, four main types of viviparity are found in insects. One is called ovoviviparity, second in adenotropic viviparity, third one is pseudoplacental viviparity, and the fourth one is hemocoelic viviparity. So we take one by one. Ovoviviparity. So ovoviv means eggs may be deposited or young ones may be deposited. But now egg deposition, we know that it is called oviparous. But here, as soon as the eggs are deposited, they hatch immediately. So there is no incubation period like in case of oviparous insects. So once the egg hatches, it may take one day, 2 days, 15 days, like that, depending on the species. So that is called incubation period. So here there is no such incubation period. So once the eggs are hatched, they immediately, laid, immediately they hatch. Or sometime the eggs are hatched inside the reproductive tract of female itself and deposited. Hatched young ones are deposited outside. So when the only difference between the ovoviviparity and other three types of viviparity is that here embryos are not nourished from the parent, okay, but yolk supply nutrients. So whereas in case of all the other three types of viviparity, in fact, they are directly nourished from the parent. Here the yolk in fact nourishes the eggs. So ovoviviparity occurs in case of some cockroaches, Blattidae, aphids and scale insects, few beetles, thrips, and also some flies like Musidae, Calliphoridae, and Tachinidae. So aphids, in fact, have adapted to all types of reproduction. They may sexually reproduce or asexually reproduce. So like this, they lay the eggs, young ones directly. Aphids and in cockroaches, this type of ovoviviparity is found. So not all cockroaches, some species of cockroaches, of course. The second one is adenotropic viviparity. So here the egg hatches inside the uterus itself, inside the reproductive system of female itself. And the larva survive by feeding on the accessory gland secretions. Okay, so the accessory gland secretions will nourishes the young one. And the fully grown larva is deposited and immediately it pupates. Okay, so what happens here? The egg hatches inside and it is nourished by the reproductive accessory glands. And once it almost matures, it is laid and immediately it pupates. So it occurs in case of seed sea fly, Glossina species. And seed sea fly is not there in India, of course. Okay. Dark fly belongs to Hippobasidae, very common. So you might have seen so some of the flies sucking the blood from the ducks. So like they may be winged or less developed winged Hippobasids. Dark flies are common. So they lay the young ones, matured young ones, on the soil, and they go to depth of about 2 to 3 centimeters and pupate immediately. So which is called adenotropic viviparity, where the young ones are nourished within the reproductive system of female. Whereas the third one is called pseudoplacental viviparity, which occurs in few aphid species and also socids and earwigs, especially belongs to family called Emimeridae and Rhizinidae, which live on mammals such as rats and bats, where eggs or embryos are nourished by special placenta-like structure. So there will be a special placenta-like structure, in fact, connected to the reproductive organ, which nourishes the young ones. The young ones are laid upon hatching. Okay, so the hatches inside and the young ones are deposited, which is called pseudoplacental viviparity. Next one is hemocoelic viviparity. So here, eggs are released into the hemocoel, and now the eggs are nourished by the blood. That means, so the eggs are directly released into the hemocoel, and the blood in fact supply nutrients to the eggs. So development occurs within the hemocoel of parent female. So occurs in case of Strepsiptera. Okay, Strepsipterans, okay, they are parasitic insects. They are very small, minute, like leafhoppers, bees, they parasitize. The difference between the Strepsiptera and Diptera is that you can see here, in case of Diptera, hindwing is developed as halteres, whereas in case of Streptoptera forming is developed as Altair. So in fact, it is called pseudo-Altair. Okay. So they are parasitic insects. And even in case of Cecidomyidae, they are called Galmidges. Okay. So that are pedogenic. That means pedogenic, we'll discuss later. So pedogenic means they have the ability, the immatures have the ability to reproduce. Pedo means young ones. So they are able to reproduce as sexually mature larva. Sometimes they do, reproduce sexually, where this type of hemocelic viviparity has been found. So eggs are released inside the hemocelid cell and they are nourished through the hemolymph. So occurs in case of Strepsiptera as well as in case of Galmidge, they are called Cecidomyids. Okay, so let us discuss about the asexual reproduction. So sexual reproduction may be oviparous or they may be viviparous. So asexual reproduction occurs through three mechanisms. One is called parthenogenesis, which is called development of egg without fertilization. Pedogenesis, where immature forms can reproduce, either larvae or pupae have the ability to reproduce. And polyembryony, where production of two or more embryos from one egg by subdivision occurs. So we'll take the parthenogenesis in a later slide. Pedogenesis means immature forms reproduction. Okay, reproduction of young ones through larvae or pupae. So it may occur in case of Galmidges, okay, Cecidomyids, not all species again. Micromaltha species belongs to Coleoptera. These two are example for larval pedogenesis. They give birth to other larvae, occasionally even they lay the eggs as well. And Myaster species, another Cecidomyid in fact, where pupal pedogenesis occurs. That means pupae has the ability to reproduce. So polyembryony, production of two or more embryos from one egg. Okay, so single egg actually subdivide and gives rise to more number of young ones. Found in case of parasitic insects such as Platygastridae. So Platygaster species. Okay, so now we'll take up the parthenogenesis. So parthenogenesis may occur under different conditions. In fact, some of the insects can reproduce parthenogenetically as well as sexually. So we'll take up based on occurrence. Okay, based on occurrence, under what circumstances this parthenogenetic condition occurs. Facultative parthenogenesis. Okay, so egg development without fertilization only under certain circumstances. Okay, only when the condition requires. Okay, some of the insect species resort to facultative parthenogenesis, which occurs in case of honeybees. We know that honeybees, the queen can reproduce drones if the eggs are unfertilized. Okay, it's called facultative parthenogenesis. Obligatory parthenogenesis. Insects solely reproduce parthenogenesis. Okay, there is no other mechanism. That means males of these species are not known to exist. Okay, so occurs in case of some species of aphids, stick insects. So of course, in case of stick insects, males are not found. Cyclical parthenogenesis, where insects of this kind reproduce sexually as well as parthenogenetically in a cyclical manner. Okay, so especially this type of reproduction occurs in case of temperate aphids. Okay, they undergo parthenogenetic reproduction during summer season, and during winter they undergo sexual reproduction. So the next one is sporadic parthenogenesis. Insects of this kind undergo parthenogenesis only under certain physiological conditions. So some variation in the physiology leads to sporadic parthenogenesis. Occurs in case of Chironomids. Okay, also in some species of aphids. So in fact, aphids are example for most different kinds of sexual reproduction as well as the asexual reproduction. So parthenogenesis based on the sex of offspring produced, whether males are produced or females are produced or both sexes are produced. Arinotoki means only males are produced. So bees and many hymenopterans produce only the males. So only males are produced through parthenogenesis, which is called arinotoki. Thinitoki, only females are produced. So stick insects, where the males are not known to exist. Okay, so only females are produced, which is called thinitoki. Ampitoki or deuterotoki, both males and females are produced. So some of the wasps like Cynipidae, one family is there in Hymenoptera. Ants, Lycophila. Okay, so few of them also produce both males and females. So based on the sex of offsprings, three types of parthenogenesis have been identified. So I was telling that sexual reproduction is common and where male and female gonads are found in two different individuals. Whereas in species of Iceria are the commonly called cottony cushiony scale, belongs to family Monophlemidae, They are immature insects, in fact, monotremates, are female-like but possess an ovotestis. So that means it possesses both the gonads, both male gonad and female gonad in a single individual, which occurs only in case of individuals belongs to genus Iceria. Okay, so they are commonly called cotton inclusion scale, where male and female gonads are present in one insect. Okay, so hermaphroditism is nothing but the production of young ones. They have the ability to lay the eggs where male and female gonads are present in a single insect, which is called hermaphroditism, which occurs only in case of Iceria. So in reproductive system, we studied male reproductive system consists of pair of testes, follicle, seminal vesicle and accessory glands, whereas female reproductive system consists of pair of ovary, ovarioles, bursa capillatrix, spermatheca and accessory glands. So insects may reproduce sexually or asexually, and many are oviparous and few of them are viviparous. Viviparity includes adenotrophic viviparity, pseudoplacental viviparity, hemocoelic viviparity and ovoviviparity. Okay. Asexual reproduction includes parthenogenesis, which is common, polyembryony and pedogenesis also occurs. So hermaphroditism occurs only in case of Iceria. Okay, so to look back, some of the questions you may have to check. Our reproduction in immature stage is known as hermaphroditism occurs in spermatheca is a part of whether it is male or female reproductive system. Okay, because of so many number of S, seminal vesicle, okay, spermatheca, spermatheca gland. Okay, you may get confused whether this is a part of male or female reproductive system. So then definitely you may have to read 2-3 times in order to better understand the systems. Adenotrophic viviparity occurs in which group of insects? Only males are produced in dash type of whether it is adenotrochy or thiliotrochy. Number of ovarioles in termites are okay. Actually, termites will have more number of ovarioles. Okay. So thank you very much. If there are any questions, you can post below or you can email me as well. Thank you.